humble to one another. He said the first benefit of this is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you his pleasness. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with the person who is humble and who is practicing this beautiful sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sunnah rahmi. This is the first benefit. Nabi sallallahu and As-Samarqandi rahimahullah mentioned the second benefit of adopting this beautiful quality of sunnah rahmi is that it makes a mu'min, a Muslim happy, or it makes an insan happy. And making a person happy itself is a sadaqah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to the extent that when you show a smile to someone, when you smile to someone, it is a sadaqah. It is a sadaqah. Unfortunately, we have not adopted this quality, others have adopted. So fulfilling the rights of the mu'min and humbling yourself in front of mu'min is also sadaqah. The third benefit, As-Samarqandi rahimahullah mentioned, that when a person becomes when a person becomes humble in front of others, then even the malaika becomes pleased with this person. Because remember, the malaika are the one when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was created insan, they asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that they would come on the earth and they would do evil. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to the malaika that there will be some who will be better than you. So even the malaika brags about those who are kind and humble to Muslims and to non-Muslims. And the fourth benefit, As-Samarqandi rahimahullah mentioned, of adopting this beautiful quality of humbleness and kindness, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put the love of those who are sila rahmi or who practice sila rahmi into the heart of the common human. There are many people, mashallah, who didn't have enough wealth or enough means to benefit others. But when they come to the masajid, when they come to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, people like to sit with them. Because they are humble, because they are kind, and they are sila rahmi people. And the fifth benefit, As-Samarqandi rahimahullah mentioned, that Iblis, the leader of shaitan gets sad and mad when people do good to one another. The Iblis becomes angry and he becomes sad. In fact, in the long hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Iblis, when in the evening he asks all his workers that what did you do? Some say we made the human to commit robbery, we made the human to commit zina. And then there is one weak shaitan that comes and says, I have made a husband and a wife fight. And shaitan hugs him, and Iblis gets so happy, he hugs him. Because he went against the sila rahmi. So it is really important for you and I, my friend, that we humble ourselves. We humble ourselves, especially to those who are turning their faces away and who are not trying to get along in a relationship with us. And then the sixth benefit, As-Samarqandi rahimahullah mentioned, in fact it is proven from Al-Bukhari. Imam Bukhari rahimahullah mentioned this beautiful hadith that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the benefit of salah rahmi are two. Number one, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless that person with a long life. And every time Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says the long life is beneficial, that means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not only bless you with long life, but rather Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you a life in which you will do good deeds and your status will get higher and higher on the day of Qiyamah. This is the good long life. And then the second benefit, Imam Bukhari rahimahullah mentioned in his book, in Adab al-Mufrad, that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put barakah in the rizq of a person who practice this beautiful quality of sila rahmi that was practiced by Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and by all the tabi'in, by all the tabi tabi'in, by all the anbiya alayhi wa sallam wa tasleem. Dear brothers and sisters of Islam, inshallah we'll conclude on the hadith in which Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed you and I the consequences of not getting along with one another, not letting going not letting go of each other's mistakes and each other's shortcomings, and not being sila rahmi or sila rahim with one another. The Messenger of Allah alayhi wa sallam says in a beautiful hadith that la yadkhulu al-jannata. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says laysa la yadkhulu al-jannata qati'u rahim. That whoever breaks the ties, whoever is arrogant, whoever is not practicing the beautiful sunnah of him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of sila rahmi, will not enter the Jannah. Will not enter the Jannah. So dear brothers and sisters in Islam, let us take advantage of this beautiful day. Alhamdulillah, we made many ibadat and we worship many to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We fast during the month of Ramadan, we stood in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven all our sins. Let's take advantage of this beautiful day. If you and I have any relationship that is not working well, or many times we have our close friends or our close family members whom we have not talked to for weeks or for months or for years, let us take advantage of this day. The benefit of this day is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has softened the heart of all the mu'min and of all the Muslims. So let us take advantage of this day. If you think that you have someone, after the khutbah, after you leave the masjid, call him. Apologize if it was your mistake. Or even if it was not your mistake, let us start a new relationship with human as we have started a new day and we have started a new relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to unite with one another. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the love of each other into our hearts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for you and I to work with each other with softness, with humbleness, with coolness. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Inshallah, now we will pray Salatul Eid. And before we perform Salatul Eid, I will mention the tariqah, the way how to perform Salatul Eid. Inshallah. Before we do the Salatul Eid, I would like to remind myself and everyone that it is wajib. It is wajib for every Muslim, male and female, or whoever has born before the day of Eid, to pay Zakat al-Fitr. Zakat al-Fitr is wajib. In the hadith, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that it is the kafara. It is the makeup for all the mistakes and all the shortcomings that one has committed during the month of Ramadan. So if you have not paid Sadaqat al-Fitr or Zakat al-Fitr, go ahead and pay before we perform Salat al-Eid, because it is wajib to perform, it is wajib to pay Zakat al-Fitr before we perform Salat al-Eid. So I would like to request all the brothers who have forgotten or for any reason they have not paid Zakat al-Fitr, get up inshallah and pay Zakat al-Fitr, which is $8 minimum. You can pay more than that inshallah, but the minimum amount is $8 per person. So if you have child that is body or nobody, mature or immature, you still have to pay on behalf of every soul. Every soul that has gone before the day of Eid, it is wajib upon him to pay Zakat al-Fitr. Inshallah, now we will go over the tariqah and over the steps of how we will perform Salat al-Eid. Salat al-Eid is not very complicated, inshallah. It's very easy. In Salat al-Eid, we have six extra takbirat. Three extra takbirat in first raka'ah and three extra takbirat in second raka'ah. In first raka'ah, we will do three extra takbirat. After Imam says Allahu Akbar, we will put our hands back, we will read Thana. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika wa tabarak asmuka wa ta'ala jadduka wa la ilaha ghayru. And then Imam will raise his hands, Allahu Akbar, and will let them hang him. Allahu Akbar the second time, and the third time when Imam says Allahu Akbar, you put your hands back. And then the Imam will recite Al-Fatiha and then the Surah. And then he will complete the Raka'ah. Second Raka'ah, Imam will get up and will recite Al-Fatiha and the Surah. And then after reciting the Surah, Imam will say Three times Allahu Akbar, and every time we raise our hand, when Imam says Allahu Akbar, and we let them hang you. Allahu Akbar, and then we let them hang you. The fourth time when Imam says Allahu Akbar, we should not raise our hand, rather we will just go in the ruku and we complete the second rakah. So in the first rakah, we will do three extra takbirat before the qiraat, and in the second rakah, we will do three extra takbirat after the qiraat, before going to the ruku, inshallah. And if you forget, just cheat off of your next musalli, inshallah, of your next brother, inshallah. And inshallah, one last thing is that we will do the Arabic khutbah after the Salatul Eid. It is wajib to listen to that khutbah. I would like to humbly request all the brothers to be seated. And I would like to request